Morrighan's Yoga Kitchen. I hope you're ready for some eating. First cooking and then some eating. Gonna be moving my sign here a little bit. So we'll be cooking again tonight together, and we'll have the chats and do a little bit of yoga as well in the meantime. Oh, there's already people joining us here, Niklos. Hi guys. Good evening, Andrea. How are you? Greetings from Luxembourg. Twitch is live. Everything is live. Yes. Woo! YouTube is live. Yay! Good to see you guys. How is your week? How has everyone been? Let me know. Put in any questions in the chat room, or just let me know how your week was. Any good news? To cheer everybody up. There's some special news for today. It's a very special birthday, and to one of our very important members, Jason. Very happy birthday, belated happy birthday to you, Jason. Jason is in charge of our social media. If you've been following us on Twitch or our Facebook, he's been around, so you probably know him very well at this point. So happy birthday, Jason. This is a special cooking show for you tonight. Yes, people are already putting in happy birthday, Jason, sending you a virtual cheesecake and a Fanta from someone. Xiang was saying, hello, Andrea. Kisajman, szia, Andi, remélem, jó vagyok, köszönöm szépen. Oh, thanks, Andy. That's from Jason. Yes, happy birthday. I might sing you the song later. I'm not a great singer, but Kier Hughes says hi from Belfast. Happy birthday, Jason, and hi, Andy. How's everyone doing? Carlord was saying that. Sziasztok, hello guys. Happy birthday, Jason from Sluggery. Hamish Shirlo, hi Andrea, hope you're keeping well. I'm watching again from London. Hi, good to see you guys. It's nice to see some familiar faces or familiar usernames from week to week. I kind of start to recognize like the same people now. We're always here every Tuesday night in Morrighan's Yoga Kitchen. Good evening, nice to see you again. Greetings from Holland. This was Gloria Kuhlman. I hope you and Zoli had a wonderful weekend as well. Michael Dorian Van Dord, Paul Benfico Afonso says hello from Geneva. Hi, how are you? I'm gonna switch on these lights. This is better. You can see better now. Right guys, so happy birthday to Jason again. Tonight we are gonna be cooking in his honor. And we are going to be making two different dishes. One is going to be a veggie one. As you know, Jason is vegetarian, so one will be his special birthday vegetarian dish. Easy to make. And then we are going to be making another dish with meat. So the first one, the vegetarian, is going to be zucchini roundlets. I don't know if you call it that way or if you call it meatloaf, but it's not meat. It's going to be made out of zucchini. So zucchini meatloaf or roundlets. And then the second thing that we're going to make tonight is going to be baked onion beans with sausage. So two very hearty, when one very hearty dinner and one a little bit lighter. The zucchini is going to be a bit lighter. Good evening, Andrea and Jason. And then we have Gerini Attila. Udvula neked Andi. Sia. Zucchini loaf, yum. Hello, Andrea. Hope you're doing well and have a great day like I have today. I got being the best in my school with a row of A in all my subjects. I'm a big nerd. That's good though. Good job. Well done. My week has been hard. Got to know that both a dear friend is hospitalized now. I'm traveling to see my friend tomorrow to take care of him when he gets out of hospital. Oh, I'm sending my my good wishes. I hope your friend is gonna get better soon. It's just very hard when someone is that so close to you, is personally involved in something like this, getting infected with the virus. But fingers crossed, your friend is gonna get better very soon. So I'm sending all my love. Hello, Andrea. Greetings from Leipzig, Germany. Oh, that's really lovely. Good to see you again. I'm going good overall with work in my room at home. Hope Jason has a great birthday. Yes, let's hope he has a special day. One to remember for sure with this quarantine situation. Oh my God, I'm getting hungry already. Niklos is hungry. Get some snacks quickly. Happy birthday, Jason, from Shein. Annie 3. Yeah. By the way, check out those arm muscles on me. Thanks.
Thank you, guys.
this top is showing my arms. Yeah, ugyan túl vagyok már a vacsorán, de ismét éges lettem. Mi lesz a ma esti menü? A ma esti menü cukini tócsni lesz, és sült hagymás bab kolbásszal. So I just said to our Hungarian viewers what we're going to make tonight. So I'm going to repeat it in English as well. If you're just tuning in now, we're going to be making a vegetarian dish dedicated to Jason on his special birthday. It's going to be a zucchini meatloaf or loaf, zucchini loaf. And then we're going to make a baked onion beans with sausage. So two really lovely and very easy to make dishes. So if you don't have too much time on your hands and you just want to have something really quick and easy, then these are the perfect solution for you. Perfect recipe to choose. So if you follow me here in the next 2 hours, then I'm gonna be sharing these two recipes with you. I actually love both of them. They're really, really good for you, very healthy. The beans will be full of iron and fibers, and it's all going to be very good for keeping your blood sugar level on a good level. So that's going to be very beneficial as well. So guys, if you want to have a chat, just put in questions in the chat room if you have any questions. I hope you enjoyed the video that I made for Zoli. Oh, that's for Shein, I think. Yeah. All right. Okay. So I have to talk about this for a second here. So it was Zoltan's birthday a few days ago, and Shein, one of our fans from Taiwan, she made an 8 minute long video dedicated to Zoli. Like all of the backstage videos, all of the behind the stage moments, some of the stage moments that are available to watch on Twitch. She went through hours and hours of footage and chose the best moments of Zoli on Twitch. And she made it like an 8 minute video and like cut music. It was like, there's a birthday song under it the whole time. And it was just so special and so thoughtful. Like, we watched it and we just both thought, oh my God, like, that is such a thoughtful gift. Like, it's so, so lovely. So thank you so much, Shein. That was so lovely and such a nice gesture. So Zoltan really, really enjoyed watching that. And so was I. So someone's saying in Hungarian that they don't really like the zucchini. Eat it if I have to, but oh, and then your message disappeared. Sorry, can you put it in again? Wait, még egyszer beraknál légy szíves, mert pont nem tudtam elolvasni. Yes, your video is brilliant. You're very talented, Shein. People are congratulating Shein on her video cutting skills. Carlo is saying, you're very welcome, Jason, because without you, we wouldn't be able to watch these programs. Szia, Andi, remélem jól vagytok. Hello, everyone. Cannot believe Food Network is here again. I'm really excited and very hungry. Who's that? I can't see. Katlinka is very hungry. She's ready to watch the... Yeah, a cukini kivételével nagyon jó hangzik, de azt is megeszem, ha nagyon kell. Good cooking and yoga. I need to go run tonight with my dog. Attila... was saying, okay, so that was the end of that first message that I couldn't watch or I couldn't read, that he doesn't really like the zucchini. You can make this with eggplants as well, or you can kind of swap the the vegetable to anything really that you like. It's just this one is with zucchini, but if you like eggplant better, you can try and experiment with that as well. Can we watch that video? Kishlein Monsi was asking. Yes, I believe that it's on Facebook, on the Lord of the Dance page, and also Zoltan shared it on his own Facebook page. So if you go on Lord of the Dance's Facebook page, then you will definitely find it there. So you can watch it. It's so lovely. Like, it's so nice to watch. You can check the Lord of the Dance fan page. Jason shared the video there. Someone else was saying that. Yeah, zucchini loaf. Can't wait for the zucchini loaf. Hello from Germany. Jasmine Blay was saying hi to all of us. Hi, Jasmine. Good to see you. How are you doing? I hope everybody is feeling great this week. I'm feeling really good and very excited about tonight's stream. We'll be doing some great recipes. We'll be cooking away and we'll be doing some yoga as well. So if you guys want to watch along, that's great. If you want to join in when I do yoga, that's totally fine as well. It's just quick and easy and very beneficial few movements that I usually show, and it's very easy to follow. So if you guys want to give it a try, then just go ahead and don't hold yourself back from trying it. Everyone's saying thank you for the about sharing the video. I think hello from Germany. Yeah, okay, right guys, so I'm gonna get the zucchini out from the fridge, so I'm just going to get ready and start preparing this meal. So I'm using yellow zucchinis because that's what I got. You can use the green ones. This one is just from like a farmer company that I sometimes order from. Very fresh vegetables, and this one was seasonal, so this is what they sent me. So I'm gonna first cut the ends of the zucchini. So I'm gonna cut the two ends off, and then I'm going to peel. Sorry, I'm just getting my board here. So I'm just gonna cut the ends and gonna throw them out. So we are making zucchini loaf first, which is the vegetarian dish for tonight. And then the second thing we're going to make is baked onion beans with sausage. So it's gonna be a very hearty dish. So just if you want to come along, just stay with us, keep asking questions. Does the color of the zucchini make any difference to the flavor? Maybe slightly, but it's basically the same thing. It could be just like a tiniest little bit different, but these are just seasonal right now, so they are pretty much the same. It's maybe like a tiny little bit of flavor difference, but not too much. Wow, I've never seen a yellow zucchini so far. Yeah, I know. I haven't really like seen one in the store, but ever since I've been ordering things from this company, they're called. So I'm going to say this in Hungarian to the Hungarians, if they want to order from this company, they're called Neked Terem. And they are basically in contact with a lot of small farmers, like family businesses and things like that. And they get all the fresh vegetables and fruits and some meat and things from these smaller companies, smaller families. And this was very seasonal, this yellow zucchini. So this is the first time I'm making yellow zucchini. So I think it's going to taste really nice, but we're just going to need to see. So I'm going to first, as I said, I'm going to peel. I'm going to peel the zucchini so we can just chat away. I'm just peeling them at the same time. As I'm chatting to you guys, I think we got a new follower. Mia Lili. Well, good luck to me trying to pronounce all these names, usernames. Some of them are really hard to pronounce. So, I'm just gonna, whoever is joining, for Lili, who just joined, So I'm making zucchini loaf and I'm going to peel them first, and I already cut the ends of it. I cut them off, so I'm not using those parts. I'm just peeling. This is a special type of zucchini. It's yellow color. It's the taste is still going to be very similar to the green one. I might actually look it up because I haven't even done a research about the yellow zucchini. So I'm going to look it up on Google and just see if there's any difference. Or if anybody wants to look it up and want to put it into the chat room, I wouldn't mind, because my hands are a little bit busy right now, so I won't be able to type away. But if you guys have a bit of time on your hands, then I would love to know about that. Yeah, Andy, I think most of us are still digesting that lovely cake that you did last week. I hope Carlord is saying that. Yeah, that's funny. Did you make it, Carlord? Have you tried making that that cake? Because it was really, really easy to make. I hope people actually try sometimes, because it is like very easy to do these kind of recipes. Like anyone can basically do them. So I hope that some of you might try these. I bet they both taste great. Hi there, Andrea. I can't read that. The green zucchini. Oh, sorry. Can you put that in again? There was something, a question about the green zucchini and asking if I could say it in Hungarian. Mary Jose Pro says, hello from Mexico, Andrea. Hope you're doing well. Hi, how are you? Good to have so many different nationalities on this channel. Something about shoes into tap shoes during the end of the first half. Oh, I think that question was about when we do LOD, two girls into LOD, and there's a quick shoe change for the two lead girls. Which is, first it feels like it's going on like for a really short period of time, especially when you're doing it for the first time and you're a bit nervous. But the more you do it, the more you get used to it. So it's actually so much more time than what you think. But if you guys subscribe to our Twitch channel, Jason actually filmed that specific part so many times, so you will definitely be able to watch that back and just see like how exactly we are when we're doing that quick shoe change in the backstage. What is the difference between the yellow and the green zucchini in Hungarian, please, if I may? Thanks. Yeah, Attila was asking. So I just said before that I actually haven't done the research about like if there is a difference. I believe there's not a huge difference. Maybe it's just a little bit, tiny a bit in maybe in the texture of it or a little bit of the color. But if anyone can look it up, because I'll be cutting away and I won't be able to look it up yet. And these recipes will as well go into my Lord of the Dance recipe binder. Yes, this is so nice. I love that. I'd love to see a photo of that. Larky, yeah, Larky was making that recipe collection. I want to be a chef. Who's that? Mia Lilili. Oh, Mia Lilili. Right, great. That's a great profession. I'm actually just kind of like, you know, like it's my hobby. I love cooking. I'm one of the leads in Lord of the Dance. This is for Lilili, who just joined. So I'm one of the dancers in Lord of the Dance. I'm playing Morrighan, the bad girl in the show, and I'm also the female dance captain. And then in this channel, I share my favorite recipes with the people who follow us. And also, I'm doing some yoga, which is a great passion of mine. I love that. It's just very calming for the mind and great for the body. And I find it just the perfect cross training for Irish dancing. So I'm sharing some of that experience with you guys here as well. Checked it. There's no difference in taste. Thank you. Who is that? Niklos. Yeah. So that's why I kind of assumed. Sometimes even with like other types of like, you know, some of the little tomatoes, there's so many different colors, but sometimes there's not that big of a difference in the taste. So it's just different types, I guess, like different colors. Right, so I'll be grating these. And then And then we are going to put it aside for 15 minutes because it's going to get very juicy. And we don't want the loaves to be too runny. So we're just going to... I'm using this part of the cheese grater I'm showing you. So the big part, the big holes I'm using. Here. I'm a fan of cooking. Mia Lilili. Yay, good. Then you're at the right place because we're doing everything related to cooking. I'm trying to cover as many parts and things as possible. These are mainly kind of easy recipes, easy to follow, and that we're able to do or make in a few hours here. How do I send a picture of the binder to you? I think I tried adding you on Instagram a couple of days ago. Oh, sorry, I sometimes don't check if people add me because it's hard to keep track of that, but I will have a look and try and then try to find you there. If you tweet it at the official Lord of the Dance account, yeah, that's also a solution. If you're up on Twitter, then just it's probably the easiest thing and it will get to us. I'm good, thanks. Mary Jose Pro was saying, what are you cooking today? Greetings to Zoltan. Yeah, so I'll be cooking zucchini loaf, a vegetarian dish, and then I'll be making baked onion beans with sausage. So that will be the two things that we're going to make tonight. So I'm just gonna, as I said, I'll be grating these zucchinis. I already peeled them. I cut the two ends off, so I chopped it off. And now I'm just using a cheese grater, pretty much just a basic cheese grater to grate them. So this is what's happening right now. Sheila Roebuck says, hi Andrea from Rotherham in South Yorkshire. Are you in Ireland? No, I'm in Hungary. I'm in Budapest right now. I live here, and then I just usually travel to wherever the show travels, but this is my base. This is where I live with my husband, Zoltan, who you can also see every Thursday night, the power hour workouts and chats. So yeah, this is our base, Budapest. Happy birthday, Jason. Hope you're having a great day. Yay. People are still wishing happy birthday to Jason. Zakaria Aswoo saying stay safe. Happy birthday, Jason. Have you ever cut your fingertip on a grater? Yes, I have to be careful because as I'm chatting, the zucchini is getting smaller and smaller. So I'm actually going to, for a second, just look down because I'm just chatting away and I actually almost did chop off my fingertip a little bit with the grater. But I'm fine now. That's good. It's good that you mentioned that because it actually was about to happen. It wouldn't have been good for tonight's cooking stream either. Is Zoltan going to cook with you 1 week, Andrea? Angela was asking. Yeah, we can make it. We can do like a special appearance week where like maybe Zoltan can join me in the cooking channel on Tuesday and I can join him in the workout stream on Thursday or something like that. Would you guys like that? Would you want a special appearance or a guest appearance on each other's channels? Would you want to see Zoltan here cooking with me and maybe me doing his workout or helping him out and demonstrate some of the movements while he's talking or something like that? Let me know what you think of that. Right, guys, keep going with the questions. The first couple of evils, Zoltan and Andrea. Yeah, any sightings of cheese me? Oh, actually, sorry, I haven't showed you where he is, but he is in the house and he's just down taking a nap. If anybody can see under the table, wait, I'm trying to point out. So he's sleeping on that chair. I think it's that chair where I'm pointing right now. Just kind of dark there. I don't want to switch on the lights on him. But Cheesme, our neighborhood cat, who drops in every once in a while to see us. is in the house. You always see him most of the time when you're watching either Zoltan or my channel. But I'm sure he will wake up at one point and then you can all see him. Thank you for saving Andrea's fingers. Yes, thanks, guys. Thanks for watching out for me. And we need more of Zoltan eating the cooking and making us all jealous. Okay, then we'll do that next time. Yes, please do it. It is too dark. Oh, it's too dark to see the cat. Yeah, I know. It's a bit dark there. I think that's why he's sleeping there, because it's just cozy and he's feeling good there. What's your favorite memories when you go on tour in Lord of the Danza? Korea Aspud was asking. Oh, so many special memories, but maybe one of them was a very special surprise. One of the years, Zoltan and I were in a different troupe. Lord of the Dance had three troupes at the time. There was one on Broadway, there was a touring troupe in Europe, and then there was another one based in London in the West End, in the Playhouse. And so Zoltan was a dance captain in the European touring troupe, and I was on Broadway, and we were not supposed to see each other for like probably 3 months altogether. And he was supposed to come out at the end of that tour, finish the tour together, and then go home or something like that. And the first week, pretty much one day before the premiere, I was actually really missing him. And I was talking to one of the girls in the dressing room. I was like, oh, I wish Zoltan was here. And I was kind of a bit like sad and missing him. And then like my friend, she used to dance in the show Maureen Devereaux, and she was like making this really strange facial expression. And I was like, what is going on with her? She was like very surprised face. And so then I looked around behind me, and there was Zoltan standing at the dressing room door, and I actually thought I was going to faint. I thought I saw a ghost. I was like, how are you here? Like, I literally was just talking about missing you and like wanting to have you here. And then I turned around and he was there, and I have no idea how he kept it a secret, because so many people knew, but some of them didn't know it was a secret. And they, for some reason, like, never said to me, like, when is Zoltan coming? And so I just turned around and he was there. So that was a great story, a great experience for me when he did that. I hope everything is going all right in Budapest in the moment. I keep hoping for good news in London. Hamish Shirlo was saying, yeah, so the current situation in Budapest is quite good. We're getting really good numbers, kind of really low. Maybe we have about like 30-ish cases every day, which is like obviously like a lot less than it was before. And Budapest had the restrictions kind of eased from this Monday, so we're allowed to go to cafes and restaurants if you're sitting outdoor in like a terrace, an outdoor terrace or a balcony or something like that, obviously keeping a distance with the other tables. So many things are changing. You can do more and more, and it's almost even better at the countryside. You can do more in the countryside, and so things are slowly getting back to kind of normal. Obviously you still have to be very careful, wear the mask, gloves, and social distance, and you know, don't get silly, but it is getting better. So that's giving us a little bit of hope that maybe the summer will be, you know, obviously not a normal summer, but like something similar to a normal season in the country. So yeah, I'm so back, should call my parents. Yeah, I remember during last year's summer tour in Budapest, Jason had both you and Zoli on the stage before the show, and you both looked cute together, so cute together. Thank you, Carlord is saying that. Yeah, it was a special, so I'm just going to put salt on the zucchini, just so while we're chatting here. And then now I'm going to put this aside for 15 minutes, because there's going to be a lot of water, juice coming out of this zucchini, which I'm not going to need for the loaf. So we're just going to put this aside I'm gonna set a timer because I might chat away so much that I forget about it. So just 15 minutes, you know, you will see like there will be more and more juice. So we just wanna first get rid of that juice. Dying to get a haircut. Jason. Yeah, hopefully soon you'll be able to go to hairdressers. Can you not cut your own hair? No? Have you ever tried? And someone was asking, can you visit your family? So like officially I'm not going because obviously I'm still very precautious. It's not advisable to go near your elderly. So like I do see my grandparents, but I see them just through the window, or if I see them in the garden, that I just keep a really, really big distance. I'm not going near them. And also my godmother, she lives there as well. We have like a generation house when I go over there. But because we quarantined with my brother, Bundy, when we came back from tour, when the whole world went crazy and the whole world literally shut down, and we had to come back earlier from our tour, which was very unfortunate. But my brother quarantined with us. So even after he moved back home with my mom, we kept that kind of group close. So we were seeing each other, but we were mainly outdoors, outside in the garden doing stuff. So it's still nice to see them. Or I went to see my grandma just from the car. She lives up on like a second level in a house, and so we were just down on the street. It was her birthday, so we went and we held up signs and waving to her and stuff like that. So, but that's as far as I go close to them, you know. Yes, Andy, we are seeing ease of restrictions slowly in the States. Still being careful though. Yeah, just be careful. Obviously, it went so much worse in the States and in the UK as well. So I understand that the restrictions are still there. And actually, last night I talked to my two friends from America and one of my friends from Australia, Hiromi, who's our physical therapist in the show. And like we were all like just exchanging information, just catching up with each other, and like everyone just told each other their experiences. And I know it's still very strict in the States, and especially in some of the areas, or some of the states are worse than others. So you just still have to be careful. Yeah, Australia is much better with the numbers, and they were really strict about everything. So I think they're slowly getting there as well, but they don't want to get too excited and then just make it all go back to what it was. So Mary Jose Pro says, oh, what a beautiful surprise. Thanks for sharing that memory. Yeah, it was so nice. Yeah, I think that was to the story that I said about Zoltan when he came to New York to surprise me. It was so nice. I tried cutting my own hair last night and yeah, no. Jason, oh no, help. Hashtag help. You can ask, maybe next week Zoltan, or no, maybe this week Zoltan can do a tutorial of how to cut your own hair. Because he does cut his own hair, so maybe he can do a live stream on for boys how to solve this problem in quarantine. Yes, the restrictions in Nottingham are easing slowly, but we're getting there. Yes, yeah, slowly but surely, guys. Just hang in there. We will all get there, but just try to be patient. And I know it's really hard. Like, we've all been in the same situation, so many of us. You know, we didn't lose our job, but we lost some of our work. So a lot of us are, in the same situation. But we just need to support each other and just be patient and believe that this is going to end one of the days, and just keep focusing on things that, you know, make you happy. Do something every day that, you know, just kind of helps recharging your batteries, that is like making you really happy. So just try to stay positive, and we'll all get through it slowly but surely. There is a light at the end of the tunnel now, so hopefully. Obviously, there are still many questions about how to live our life after this whole thing ends. But, you know, just try not to lose faith we will get there, you know? Just keep watching this channel, keep cooking away, focusing on cooking, and you'll be fine. Yes, Zoltan's evil hair studio. Yeah, maybe we could do the evil hair studio next week. Zoltan's evil hair studio, I love this. The Dark Lord haircut show. That would be funny. He actually just cut a very special haircut for himself. I'm not gonna reveal it right now, but you will see on Thursday. He might explain it. And if you guys are gonna be watching, then maybe suggest him to do an evil hair cutting show one of the weeks. Everyone gets exactly the same Dark Army haircut. He actually might cut Bondi's hair, my brother's hair, similar to his, so maybe he could be the model, and he can just demonstrate it on Bondi's hair, how he cuts hair. In Wales, we're on a traffic light system at the moment. We're still in lockdown. I'm not too sure what the traffic light system is. Would you mind just explaining that? I think it was Angela. I'm just not sure what that means. Is it just at the moment we're still in lockdown? So just if you can let us know what that means, because I'm not familiar with that expression. Hello from Mexico, from Jose Luis Ojeda or Oyeda. Hi Jose, how are you? We need to live stream Zoe cutting Bundy's hair. Yeah. Yes, I would love to see Bundy again. Yeah, so maybe you could do a special guest appearance. You can chat to Bundy as well while Zoltan is cutting his hair or something. Miss Bundy. Xiang is saying missing Bundy. I would tell Bundy. yeah, he's doing really good as well, working loads in the garden. We were actually doing some sibling work in the garden yesterday. He cut one. We have this long line of bushes to kind of, you know, just to cover us from the street, hide us from the street, and that had to be cut. So Bundy cut it, and then I just kind of thought maybe it could be a bit more straight rather than like kind of wavy. So then I went up on the ladder as well, and I was cutting the top of the bushes, trying to keep it straight. And Bundy was like at one point holding the ladder, because we have like a surface that is kind of uneven. So sometimes I was feeling like I'm going to like fall right on the top of the bushes. So I asked Bundy to hold the ladder for me. So yeah. Hi, Andrea, I hope you're doing well. Yes, thank you so much. I'm doing really well. We're just going to be cooking away here. We're making a vegetarian dish, which is going to be a zucchini loaf. And we will be making a baked onion beans with sausage as well. So how do you say hello in Hungarian? Very easy. Hello. Or we also say, when we greet each other, we can say see ya. Like see ya, but just kind of shorter. See ya. Or sziasztok, if it's more people, you say sziasztok. Or you can also say szevasz. I like to say that because it's kind of like, it has like a retro feeling for me, szevasz. I say that as well. Szevasztok, if it's more people then. Happy birthday, Jason. Hope you had a great day. From Annie Wheels. Oh, that's so nice. Jason, special day. Jason, how are you celebrating today? Is there any break for you in the day for a few hours to eat, order a piece of cake or something? Or some dessert from anywhere? It just means that red is maybe seeing family and friends at a distance. Yellow is pubs and cafe may start opening. And green is everything is open but still with social distance. Oh, I see. Right. Okay. That makes sense. That makes absolute sense. Yeah, that's good. It's a good thing if you do things in moderation. Obviously the same with anything else, but especially in this situation, we just have to be careful. Obviously we've been in this situation for so many months now, like over 2 months, so our patience is running out, but we just have to kind of keep it still, you know, just be careful. When you go out there, don't feel like, oh, it's all gone, you know. Even if the restrictions are getting out, you know, don't throw them out the window completely. Just try to still have it in your back of your head that we need to kind of keep a distance for a while, and hopefully if we do so, then things will go back to normal soon. No break, but working on cool. Oh no, it went away. Jason, put it in again. Sorry, I missed what you said there. Kishnay Munsey is saying, I have watched Lolly's birthday video. Awesome. Do I see it well that one of the people is Yihan? They're sitting at a table. No, no, she wasn't. No, this was more the backstage footage from when we did the tours just recently. So Yihan wasn't there. I have booked the time to go to my old hairdresser in a month. She's in the other end of the country, Denmark, where I come from. Sometimes it's just worth waiting and traveling to get a haircut from your favorite hairdresser. I so agree. I really miss my hairdresser. I haven't been to her for such a long time. I technically could go because hairdressers were allowed to stay open. So, or they are open now. But I'm still a little bit like, I'm not sure. So I dyed my hair the other day, so no roots anymore. So I think I'm going to wait another month maybe, and then hopefully things will be a little bit better by then. Here in Luxembourg, almost everything is opened again except restaurants, cinemas. We have to wear a mask. Yes. Yeah, that's kind of a little bit similar, but we have the restaurants open, but you just can't go inside. You can go and sit outside in Budapest, but you can't go inside yet, because still Budapest is the place where the most cases came from. So this is why we still have that rule. We have it a little bit more strict than the rest of the country. So yeah. So guys, the next thing we're gonna do is that we're going to use 50 grams of cheddar cheese. So I'm just gonna grate the cheddar cheese. I'm showing you what I'm using. Dublin Dairy Irish cheddar cheese. Up the Irish, the cheese. So just gonna use this and gonna grate, get the cheese grater again. And then where is my bowl? Sorry, 2 seconds. I'm just gonna be using this in the cheese grater. So I'm preparing for the next part because we have 2.5 minutes almost until we can use the zucchini. So this is just a really easy recipe, guys. Cheddar cheese. Yes, people love the cheddar cheese, especially Jason. Jason, this is for you. The cheese. Oh. I just dropped a bit of cheese, sorry. No break here today, but working on, oh my god, super cool, top secret, Lord of the Dance stuff. Jason, come on. Stop teasing the people here. I bet like most people now thinking, what is Jason talking about? What is he possibly can work on right now? So exciting. Everything normal in Taiwan. We only need to wear the mask when we go out, have the distance when we see people. I hope everyone or everything will be normal in everyone's country soon. Stay safe and healthy, Xiang was saying. Yeah, so back in like February when we were doing the tour in China, and then we had to, obviously our shows got canceled in Beijing and we went to Taiwan a bit earlier. We actually experienced such professionalism the minute we entered the country in Taiwan. Like, people were so, like, professional. Like, at the airport, they were measuring temperature. There was disinfectant everywhere. Like, it was just, you know, like, you had to fill out a form where you came from. They registered you in the system. Like, there was obviously, you know, you could still go to places. And I think the mask wasn't... everywhere, like you didn't have to wear it everywhere, but when we went into the theater, every time they measured our temperature, they gave us the disinfectant spray, and then that's how we were able to enter the building, and then the whole of the audience had to wear the masks. So I think Taiwan had it very, very good. They had a really good system going, and people were following the rules, so maybe that's why it didn't get that bad as in many other parts of the world. I think people really followed the suggestions and rules. And look forward to seeing what you're working on, Jason. See, Jason, the people. Oh, the people want to know. They're curious here. What secret stuff is that you're working on? What's happening with Lord of the Dance? Guys, there's loads of cool stuff coming up. Loads of secrets. Loads of new things. So just keep watching us. Hopefully there will be many things that you can look forward to. So just keep watching us until we can reveal more. And watch those fingertips. Yes, thank you very much. They're all good. No cuts, no bleeding. It's all classified top secret information. Yes, that's what it is right now. But hopefully soon, you know, you guys will know more. And then we will be very happy together talking about these cool things happening in Lord. Right, so guys, we are going to be using, a clove of garlic as well. So I'm just gonna just peel it first. What I do with garlic, the way I peel it is that I usually put it, I'm trying to make it look like you can see it, right, so you can kind of see it. So I usually get the knife, I put it on top of the garlic, and then I just very gently press down on the knife onto the garlic. It kind of cracks, so that's how you kind of crack the shell. It's not the shell, it's like the outer part of the garlic, and then it just kind of comes off. Woo! Right, I'm making a mess already. I will clean it up. It's just a little bit of garlic here in the kitchen, everywhere. Okay, so here's the first big Lord of the Dance secret: 50 grams of cheese. Yes, we will eat all of that. I'm always watching, never miss the stream. Oh, that's so nice. Nicola, she's always watching us. Yes, garlic. Yes, yes, yes. Hello, Andrea. How are you? Smooth Criminal just joined us. Hey, how are you? Good to see you again. Sluggery, if it's about the 25th anniversary, just wink one. I don't know. Am I allowed to wink one? Jason, give me thumbs up if I can wink. It could be, you know, because the 25th anniversary is just around the corner, you know, so it could easily be about that. You're just going to need to keep watching and wait for someone to drop information about what's going on. But right now, we're cooking, trying to keep in shape. Obviously, some of the weeks we made some cakes, even last week we made a cake, but I was thinking that I'm going to do... next week, I might be doing a vegan cooking channel because I know there's a lot of people who either voluntarily became vegan or they have some kind of intolerancy or allergic to some type of food or some type of ingredients. So I think I was thinking that would be interesting. Let me know what you think. You think that's something that you would be interested in, and I can look into some of the vegan recipes. And this zucchini loaf is actually not going to be vegan, it's just going to be vegetarian, because I'm gonna put an egg into the mixture, and I think dietary people don't eat any eggs either, but let me know if that's true or not, or if you know better. I think they don't eat eggs, but if there's anyone else who's more of an expert in vegan diet, then just let me know. I think I'm pretty sure that it's no eggs for them, so this is just vegetarian, not vegan. Right, so I'm going to now move on with my recipe. So I have the zucchini here. You can kind of see, I'm gonna wash my hands quickly because I wanna just show you something. So So, right, so I just want to show you how it looks like, the texture. Yeah, vegan, no eggs, dairy, lard, gelatin, meat, fish. Yeah, yeah, that's why I kind of assumed that there's no eggs either, no eggs involved. Dance for Hope audience numbers are exploding right now, Niklos was saying. Oh my God, that's amazing. Yeah, I watched it. It was actually really creative, like all the kids and all the dancers came up with such great ideas. So it's nice to see how it's taken on. Same here, but I have a hint of what it is. Oh, Car Lord. What do you know? What do you know? yes, it will be interesting to see the vegan recipes. Yes. Okay, good. So people find it a good idea. So I'm happy about that. Right. So what I'm going to show you in a minute here. Sorry, I'm just going to need another bowl. Just bear with me. I'm back here. Right. So I'm just going to want to show you how this whole thing looks like. So you can kind of see that it's all very kind of juicy. So I'm just going to grab a handful of the grated zucchinis. And I am going to be pressing my two palms together. And I'm trying to get rid of all the water. You can probably see on the camera, if you're watching at the blue part of my t-shirt, that there is a ton of water coming out of this. Performing warlord steps. Oh my God, Jason, are you serious? I completely missed that. Is it true? Me. Oh, I'm not sure. What did Jason say? I think I missed that comment. What's happening, guys? I'm missing out of the fun. What's happening? Put it back in again. Someone put the message in. I was just looking at the zucchinis and getting a bowl. Maybe smooth criminal. Maybe. Who here got a kick out of seeing Andy performing warlord steps? Oh, yeah, guys, I was performing some of the warlord steps. even on tour, do you remember, Jason, we were chatting, and then I don't know how, Alistair, Spencer, and Jason and I were just chatting on Twitch, and then somehow we just came up with this idea that I should, maybe I was trying to prove a point or something, I don't know what it was. So, Alistair got the hat from the warlord's number, the black hat that the guys wear, and then I just started dancing some of the steps from warlords, and then obviously for the video that we did, Dance for Hope, we did parts of the video as well. I learned one of the little lead bit when the lead is doing like a bit of clapping and stuff, which was fun. It's a bit of a challenge for me, so I practiced it loads. I loved it. I actually really enjoyed it. It was so much fun making that video, preparing and doing the boys steps. Many are watching it now because we were told like a minute ago that there's a big hint in the end of it. Oh, at the end of the Dance for Hope video, or which version? Dance for Hope 1, 2, or 3? At the end of one of them, is it? Girl power. Dance for Hope 2, Larky says. The originals 2. Ooh, very exciting, guys. What could it be? Someone go quickly watch it and let us know. Girl Power, Dance for Hope 2. I need to watch it again because I'm not sure how it ends. Yeah, cool things to come, guys. Keep tuned in and keep watching our channels for more information. There is cool things happening in the background. Loads of creative work and exciting things for the future of Lord of the Dance. In the meantime, I'm cooking away here, trying to keep us healthy with these zucchini loaves in the lockdown. So if you guys wanna try this recipe, I'm just trying to drain the zucchini that I peeled before, and then I grated it, so it's very small it's in very small pieces, but there's a lot of water that came out of it. So I'm just trying to get rid of all the water. This is what you're seeing right now. If you're tuning in now and looking at me, why am I pressing my palms together? There's some zucchini inside of the palms that I'm just showing you right now. So I'm just trying to press as hard as I can so all the liquid, all the water comes out, because when we're making these loaves, we don't want them to be runny. We want it to kind of stick together, not fall apart. Kovac Sobi says, Sia. See, someone asked before how to greet in Hungarian, and this is one of the forms, Sia. So, Sia, Szevasz. Szevasz Sobi. I'm personally very curious about this recipe. May try to cook this here at home. Who's that? Jason. Jason, it could be your birthday zucchini loaf, you know? So, just try it. Yeah, it's actually really easy. You will see soon. And it's just a little bit time consuming right now because I'm doing it kind of slow as I'm chatting to you, but it's actually not that hard. I could speed up if I wanted to, but I'm just very laid back and chatty. Try it, Jason. If you do, please post a photo for us all to see. The photo would be of an entire building on fire. No, you keep saying that, but it's so not true. I think we need a vote here. Like, people could vote about Jason's cooking skills from starting from 1 to 5. What number would you give to Jason? Let's boost his confidence a little bit on his birthday, okay? So what do you think? Should Jason try this recipe tonight? Should he have enough confidence? What do you think about his cooking skill from 1 to 5? Let's give it up for Jason here. Come on, Jason, you can do it. Jason, please do it. See, the people are asking for that. Enough water to fill the sink, isn't there? Yeah, there's so much water right now. Someone could actually swim in this. This is almost basically just water, so I'm just trying to get the last little bits of the zucchini out, because they don't want to waste any of the good yellow zucchini that I got. Yeah, 5 stars, 10. Shian is giving 10 out of 5, which is double, so that's great. Come on, Jason. See, Federico was saying, see, people are really voting for you to try. Believe in yourself and try the recipe. Come on, Jason. You can do this, guys. And as you can see, I got to the end of this. So I'm showing you, I used 2 zucchinis, and see, it's this much of water that came out of it. And we have this much of zucchini. So now we're gonna make the mixture, guys. So we're going to be adding everything that we have here. So I have 1 clove of garlic that I'm gonna be adding to the mixture. So just adding that, which we all love. I know this whole group is all about garlic. So we put that in, and then we're going to put the grated cheese, 50 grams of cheddar cheese. Woo-hoo. I might just take a little, I'm just gonna check if it's still good. Mm-hmm. Very good. So guys, this can go in now. I double checked, it's fine. It's fine to go in, right? So I added the cheddar cheese. It's just, cheddar cheese is just too good. I might actually start cutting some cheese that I take out from the fridge and just eat it. Because I just love that. I just love eating little pieces of cheese as a snack. I don't know about you. I know Jason loves it, but let me know if you guys ever do that. Right, so we will be putting a little bit more salt and pepper. Remember, we already put salt on the zucchini to get all the juice, the water out. So I'm only adding a little bit on top, so I don't want it too salty. But because I pressed the water and the juice out, and probably some of the salt was lost, so I'm just re-adding that. Adding pepper to the mix. And then I'm going to be adding whole grain, rye, flour. You can use any kind of flour that you like, but I just want to keep this a healthy one. So I'm going to be measuring 30 grams of flour. So I'm just switching on my special tool. Garlic pepper though. We should all send Jason some cheese for his birthday. That's funny. Yes, Jason, let us know where we can send your birthday gift of cheese, blocks of cheese. So 30 grams, almost there. 24, 26. 30. Okay. Right, guys. So we'll be adding that to the zucchini. And then I'm going to mix the whole thing. And then I'm going to add an egg to it as well. So I'm just going to first mix the flour, the zucchini, the garlic, salt and pepper. Just mixing this. And then I'm going to be adding the egg. I'm going to be adding that to the mix. Just we'll wash the egg first. Right, guys, we're getting there now. Don't give up on this. Adding the egg. And then just quickly mixing the whole thing. Mmm, yummy. I will show you in a minute what it looks like, okay? Just so, because you haven't seen the mixture for a bit, a good bit. Mm-hmm. And then you can use this, if you're not a vegetarian, you can still make this as a side dish if you're eating something, you know, some roasted chicken or anything, and you just want some veggie on the side. You can make this as a side dish. And if you're a vegetarian, obviously this could be your main dish and you can pair it with bulgur, brown rice, quinoa, anything like that. So this is just going to be your main dish then if you're not eating meat. So I'm just showing you in the camera this. It looks a bit weird actually that I'm showing it to you. But I'm going to lift the piece, just bring it closer. So you can kind of see what it looks like. It's not runny, it's quite hard, but creamy kind of texture. So we just want to make sure that they don't fall apart. So we don't want it too liquidy. That's why we got rid of the water first. Is the grated cheddar in now as well? Yes, so now everything is in it. So I have the zucchini that I grated before. Added salt and pepper, 1 clove of garlic. I added 30 grams of flour. I used whole grain rye flour. And then I also added the 50 grams of cheddar cheese that I grated before. So everything is in here right now. So the next phase is going to be making it, guys. So we finally made it here. So I'm going to be using a pan. And then just going to switch this on. And I will be adding a little bit of coconut oil, because that's what I usually use when I cook. So guys, you don't need a lot of oil. That's the thing. So we're not going to be doing what we would do with a lot of Hungarian dishes. We're not going to deep fry them. We're just going to fry them in a little bit of coconut oil. So I just want like to show you this. This is pretty much how much I use. If you use like sunflower oil or any kind of other oil, olive oil, you just only need like a little bit to kind of cover the whole pan and like kind of just batter it a little bit, but you don't want it to be soaking because you don't want the zucchini loaves to be soggy, oily kind of. So we'll Zoltan show up at the end to eat more amazing cooking and make us all jealous. Well, you never know with Zoltan. He's not here right now, but he might show up. So let that be a surprise because he has to come home at some point. So, you know, he might be here. We never know. The hint is Planet Ireland arises in 2021. Oh, interesting. Very nice. Carlord. That was Carlord saying, I am seriously craving this zucchini dish. On Facebook, IIYA asks, what are you making? So I'm making a zucchini loaf. So I'm doing a vegetarian dish, and then I'm going to be making something with meat as well, which is going to be baked onion beans with sausage. So at the minute, we're making the zucchini loaves, and we mixed everything here. I'm showing you the mixture. So I peeled the zucchinis. Two zucchinis I used, they were both yellow. I peeled them, and then I grated them, and put salt on them, and just waited for about 15 minutes because there's a lot of water that came out of them. So then I kind of put a little bit between my palms. I pressed it hard for the water to kind of drain, and then I was putting it in a separate bowl. And then I added 30 grams of flour, 50 grams of grated cheddar cheese, 1 clove of garlic, like smashed garlic, salt and pepper. And this is where we are right now. I also added 1 egg. And then this is the mixture. So it's not too runny, it's not too hard. It's kind of like a creamy texture, creamy consistency. And we are at the minute just waiting for the coconut oil to heat up. I'm just using about this much. You can kind of see the shining parts, how much oil that is. So it's not a lot of oil. I don't want to make the zucchini loaves swim in the water or swim in the oil. Okay, it's pure healthy food. Yes, it's pure healthy. It's very healthy. Although if you're a vegan person, this is not for you because there's an egg in it. But if you're vegetarian, then it's perfect. So we have Nashka Samuel just joining our channel. Welcome, Nashka. Hi, how are you? If I could invent a Star Trek transporter to beam on this cooking to everyone all over the world, I would so do it. Do it! Try to come up with the technology for it, and then I'm sure that people would be happy. Or at least the people who follow this channel and crave the food at the end of the stream, at least them would be happy. Right, so I think the coconut oil is getting nice and hot. So I am going to use my spatula, and I'm going to be using about this much of the mixture. I'm going to put it in here, and we can already kind of hear it sizzling. Then I'm going to add another little bit, and I'm going to flatten them a tiny bit, so I don't want them to be more like a bowl. I just want them to kind of be like a flat, rounded-ish kind of shape, but I'm not too strict with myself. I'm going to be showing you. So they look like this. I kind of press down on the top of them. I'm going to be making 2 at a time because I want them both to get the same chance. And I get a plate, and I will need paper towel. Bear with me 2 seconds. I'm back, sorry. So I just needed something, just needed some paper to when I take out the zucchini loaf. And then, so what we're doing right now is just we're gonna bake it for a few minutes. I'm just gonna be purely just judging it like what I think is fine. So it doesn't have to be for too long. You just have to keep looking at it. You don't wanna burn it, but you don't wanna make it too pale either, so just give it a light color. It just should be a tiny bit hard under, so I sometimes gonna look under it. It doesn't have to be too long of a time for it to bake or to be ready. So I just want it to be kind of crispy, like lightly brown but not too dark. This is what I'm going for. We'll be switching you just to Twitch shortly. Okay, so guys, if you are watching us and you want to keep watching, the zucchini loaf. The first ones are about to get ready. And then if you want to watch me making the second dish, which is a meat dish, it's going to be baked onion beans with sausage. If you want to keep watching and want to do some yoga as well, then just go over to Twitch, subscribe to our channel, and just keep watching us. I can't eat cheese, so can I replace the cheese with something else, Andy? Angela was asking. Yeah, I'm trying to think what else you could do, put into it that could be. I would maybe try either like a little bit more of flour, or I would add like maybe some kind of like seed, like, or like oats or something, like maybe like a bit of oatmeal almost. It might not be like the best, but I just think you just need something to kind of keep it together, so it wouldn't get too runny. Right, so I'm gonna flip the first one over and I'm gonna show you before you guys go over to Twitch. So whoever's watching here, this is what it looks like. It's not too dark, but it has a little bit of a color. I'm gonna flip the other one as well. Oh guys, it smells like garlic so much in this kitchen. It's amazing if you like garlic. And I know that you guys do love garlic, so. Oh my God, I'm actually starving as well. Now I'm just making it. Most of the time I wasn't, but now I'm getting to a point where I'm just very hungry. Yeah, so guys, if you're watching here, head over to Twitch and then you can keep watching me making the rest of these zucchini loaves. Jason wants this. And Angela, thanks for answering my question, Andy. No problem. Yeah, I think first maybe I would put more flour into it and maybe just experiment, because just the texture could be a tiny bit different, but maybe the oats could be a good idea, I think, Angela. Sizzling goodness. Yes, it's sizzling away. Right, so I can see it's already getting there, so I'm just looking under. Okay, I give it another minute for the smaller one, but the bigger one is already, I'm showing here in the camera, this is the way it kind of has to look like. The first one is ready, so I'll be moving on and putting, right, I think this one should be fine as well. Okay, good. So I'll be putting more in, guys. I just don't want the oil to burn, so I'm gonna pull it off. Right, so I'll be just doing the same as before. So I'm getting a little bit portion. You can hear it sizzling. I'm gonna actually try to make three.